What's up, everybody? I'm not talking to you right now. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Nick here, and I can't believe it. We are literally in the last hour before it all begins, before summer begins. This is Nick's Big Brother 25 recap show, the season premiere. We have waited all summer. We've waited too long for this season to begin. We didn't know if it was going to happen. I'll answer you later. We didn't know if this season was going to happen because of the writer's strike, but sorry if this light is bothering you. It's not going to bother you in a minute because we're gonna get going on this thing. And I'll pop out of here so you guys can see the slides that I'm doing. But okay, we have an hour left. We have an hour before the season premiere begins. We need to get through the 16 house guests that I'm about to introduce to you. And I have to show you my final two picks. So we'll go through the list efficiently. Hopefully I get through all 16. And I haven't seen any interviews with the house guests, so I guess we're just going to be judging based on looks, which is sad to say, but I don't know. But anyway, let's get right into it because I want to make sure I talk about all 16 house guests and give you my opinions. And I'm going to put this phone on vibrate because it's bothering me. Okay. Just bear with me. This is live, as I mentioned. Gonna get this ready to go. Now let me check my window real quick. That way you don't see. Okay, so let's dive right into this, shall we? This is the Big Brother 25 recap show season premiere. Allow me to introduce you to the Big Brother 25 cast. All right, first up we have America Lopez, age 27, from Brooklyn, New York. She is a medical receptionist. All right. So right away, she's stunning. Like, she's out of my league. I could try to talk to this girl, but I think she would shoot me down. What do I think? First off the bat, I've seen clips and I've heard that she wants to flirt with the guy. So, which is what I'm getting right off the bat. She's definitely going to be one to flirt with the guys. So how could you not? How could you not want to get with this girl? Do I think she can take it to the end? I'm going to say no, to be honest, because I think what's going to happen is she's going to get in a showmance, and then that's where it gets all screwed up. Because usually showmances, only one showmance has made it to the end, and they have since broken up. So, but yeah, I don't know how far this girl will go. It's just a matter of time. We'll figure it out. But this is America. Literally, this is America. Did you catch my reference? Okay, next we have Blue Kim. That's right. You heard that correctly. Her name is Blue Kim, age 25, from New York, New York. And she's a brand strategist. Now, this I forgot to research, but I'm going to research it right now because I want to know what a brand strategist. So, so a brand strategist is a marketing professional responsible for a company's messaging and strategy. Okay, so basically a promoter or someone who comes up with the slogans or the marketing, who does marketing, trying to get the product or the company out there and, try to get them on the map. So she's got to do a lot of persuading, and she's very social. So clearly you got to be smart to do this one. So right off the bat, she looks stunning. So I think this is one that I'm going to watch for. I'm going to keep a close eye on Blue. Very original name. Very authentic, sorry. Authentic name. So I don't know. When I heard her talk, kind of gave me some weird vibes. Kind of like she's very like kind of sassy a little bit. So I hope that's not her personality. I hope she is one to get along with. She could potentially be a pick for my final two. We'll have to wait and see as we move on to Bowie Jane. DJ Bowie Jane, I should say. age 45 from Los Angeles, California. There you go. But fun fact, she was originally born in Melbourne, Australia. Yeah, that's really interesting. And I've heard her talk and I love her accent. I think she's going to be a crowd favorite. I really do. I just hope her personality is really good. I just want to make sure this is what I think it is. And no, it is not. Okay. So she is a barrister / DJ. And I just looked up the definition for barrister. Barrister. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's not what you think. You're getting confused with barista. That's not what that is. A barista is a lawyer entitled to practice as an advocate, particularly in the higher courts. Okay, so that means she's freaking smart. Follows politics. So, a lawyer. So, she's really smart, and I think these people better watch out. So, having said that, you know, I pay close attention to lawyers, because one thing is you got to know how to persuade people, win people over, have a social, be social and kind of manipulate a little bit on the defendant side or the plaintiff side, whichever side you're going to be on. So you got to know your social game has to be intact. I'm still a little iffy on if she has what it takes to be the final two. Little iffy. So, but she is a candidate. So let's move on to Cameron Harden. Oh, boy. Well, I should call him dude. Just call him dude. So Cameron Harden, age 34, from Eastman, Georgia. He is a stay-at-home dad. I bet you he's a fun dad, too. I guarantee it. He looks like he loves to have fun and has a good sense of humor. So I'm hoping that stays true when we get into the house. Do I think he has what it takes? Okay, so if he's a stay-at-home dad, I think he's got a good personality. If that is the case, then I think people will like him. They will really like, I think he will be one to make to be your friend in the house. I could see him possibly being used as a what is it called? Not the target, but the what's that word? I can't think of it. Not the target, but the pawn. I see him being a potential pawn. And if that's the case, he can slide right up to the 750K. Because he probably, you never know. That can change his life. That can change his family's life. So, but I see him being a potential pawn if he's going to make it far. So, I should go back a little bit. Let me go back to the beginning. And let me add this. Do I think America has a chance to make jury? I don't know. That one's a little iffy. Blue, I want to say yes, but at the same time, I'm like, I don't know. I don't have a good feeling. Bowie, I think, can make it to jury for sure. And I'm going to add Cameron to the list as well. So I do think Cameron can make it to jury for sure. But like I said, he could be a pawn all the way to final two. We'll see. Next, we have Corey Wurtenberger. Age 21, from Weston, Florida, college student. So there's another little twist going on right now with the casting. Two house guests are related to two contestants from Survivor this season. So I wonder if these two know about it. I wonder if these two are going to know about each other's family and their background. I guess they'll have to wait and see. Now, I did not add pictures of the relatives. I will go ahead and do that on the first recap show. But Corey has a brother. If any of you Survivor fans are out there, look up Zach Wurtenberger. Zach Wurtenberger. That is his brother who was on Survivor. So, and Survivor and Big Brother, the game is very similar. There's alliances, there's competitions to win immunity. And there's backstabbing and lying and deceit in both games. So I think Corey has a good idea on what he's walking into this season. Do I think he has what it takes to make it to the end? I don't know. I'm going to say no, and only because, and this is going to be my reason for someone later on, because if he tells, okay, he might have a shot, but if he lets anyone know that he's related to what's his name from Survivor, that will put a target on his back, and that will probably ruin his chances. So I think Corey needs to just zip, and trust that the other guy, it's going to be a guy, the other guy that is related to a Survivor contestant can keep his mouth as well. So, I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to have to pay attention to this guy, too. We'll see how what happens. He's a college student. Also, I don't know if he has what it takes. We've seen Ian Terry. He was a college student. Won the 500K in his season. Came back for All-Stars. Was the first member of the jury. I don't know. Maybe Corey can surprise me. I need to know what he's studying, though. I want to know what his major is besides college student. And that will help me determine if he will make it to the end. But for right now, I'm going to say, I don't know. Same for, is he going to make it to jury? I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. All right, here we go. We got Felicia Cannon. Hi. Let's say hi, Felicia. Not bye, Felicia, but hi, Felicia. Age 63, this is the oldest contestant of the season. By the way, I think, let me add this to Corey. Corey is the youngest house guest of the season. He's 21, so he's the youngest, the baby of the group. But the elder of the group is Felicia. Again, she's age 63. Looking stunning for 63. Come on now. Come on now. From Kennesaw, Georgia, a real estate agent. All right, so I know your social game has to be really good. Got to be able to persuade the customers over, talk to them, be friendly, get that sale out there. So I think Felicia's social game could be really good. I really do. Do I think she can make it to the end? That's a toughie. If she can, I think she could, but her journey is going to be very tough because, one, you got to win comps at some point. You can slide by the first half, but then the second half, you really have to start winning comps. And then your social game has to be phenomenal, which I think Felicia has a potential. I think she can. I do see her making jury. I think she will. I think they'll keep her. They better keep her. I'm gonna be pissed if they evict her first. So I think she has what it takes. All right. Next, we go to, I think this is how he pronounces it. It's Haisam Gueli. I'm sorry if I butchered that name. I'm going to know for sure how he pronounces it after the premiere. So I apologize if I pronounced that wrong. It's either Haisam or Haisam. Not Haisam. I think it's Haisam. Age 45 years old. I think he's, oh, him and Bowie are the second oldest contestants, or tie for the second oldest. But again, look at him, 45 years old. Sorry, the picture is kind of fuzzy because some pictures they're like up close. But if you watch the premiere, just look, he's amazing. So, age 45, from Seattle, Washington. I'm very curious as to where he was originally born, or if he was. Maybe he was born in Seattle, Washington. I want to know a little bit about his ethnicity, his background. A geriatric physician. Let me look this up real quick. Okay. So a geriatric doctor, also called geriatricians, specialize in caring for aging adults who often have complex medical issues. Okay, so he tends to the elderly, or people are of a particular age. Depends. Okay, so probably seniors, probably people of a particular age. So I expect his personality to be bubbly, very outgoing, which I think it is. I heard some of his videos. He was very like... He was energetic. I don't know. I'm gonna keep my eye on this guy. I really do. Do I think he has what it takes? I think so. I think he can make it to the end. He could definitely make it to jury for sure, and he better. But I would love for him to downplay his profession. I don't know if he should announce that he's a physician. A pediatrician. I think he should tell people that he's a pediatrician, which are a doctor that tends to the kids. That might buy him some sympathy. So we'll see. But I'm going to keep my eye on this guy. I feel good vibes with this person. So, all right. By the way, we are 44 minutes away from the premiere. All right. And we're moving along pretty quick. So what I think I can do is probably pull up a couple interviews. So we'll deal with that later. Next, we have Izzy Gleicher. Gleicher? I think it's Gleicher. Izzy Gleicher. Age 32. She is from New York, New York. And she is a professional flautist. Yes, that's how you pronounce the word. Not flutist. Flautist. Yes. I'm a band geek. I should know this stuff. And so is Izzy. So I feel good potential with Izzy. So represent. Do I think she can make it to the end? It's possible. I need to see how she does with competitions. We'll see. Because she has to have at least one under her belt. I don't know. But then again, Dr. Will, if you don't win competitions, your social game better be on point. Just like Dr. Will. So, I think so. I don't know. See, here's the thing with us band geeks. Our social games, we could be socially awkward. So, I think maybe Izzy could have issues kind of blending in with the crowd a little bit. We'll have to wait and see. Maybe she's very social and can spark up a conversation just like that. She could have an issue with lying, though. Like, telling, she's going to be honest with you, like, all the time. Maybe that could get her in trouble. I don't know. I do think she can make it to jury for sure. I do think she can make it to jury. So, but yeah, I'm going to keep an eye on this one too. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's introduce Jag Baines. By the way, I think we're halfway through our list already. Jag Baines, our very first Muslim that wears a hijab. We've had a few Muslims in the mix already, but this is the first one that wears a hijab, that which is their headwear. So, representation is important. So congratulations to you, Jag. Age 25 years old, from Omak. What is that? Washington. That's Washington. Omak, Washington. And he speaks English beautifully. You can tell he adapted to the dialect. Once, you know, when you go to like a new kind of area, a new town, a new country, whatever, it takes you a minute to get used to the dialect. So I think he must have lived here for like all his life and got accustomed to the dialect, because his interviews sounded really good. He spoke like nothing. So he was good. He's a truck company owner, so he's always on the road, making that dough. So do I think he can make it to the end? I think he could. I want to see how his competitions. I want to see how he does in competitions. He could have a good social game. A truck company owner, you know, I don't know. Well, no, he's an owner, so I don't think he's on the road a lot. So maybe he is social with people. If he puts himself out there like that, then I think he'll be okay. He'll have a good social game. We'll see how his personality seems bubbly, so that's why he's on the show. So we'll wait and see. I'm gonna watch out for Jag right here. I think he can make it. He can at least make it to jury, that's for sure. I think he will. So let's hope that he does. All right. Next, we have Jared Fields, age 25, from Norwalk, Connecticut, and he's an exterminator. It did not specify what kind of extermination. I'm guessing bugs. Exterminator. Okay, so here, listen up. This is the other contestant that is related to a Survivor contestant. His mother, Ciri Fields, C-I-R-I-E. His mother won Survivor. Not only that, but this year, she also appeared on another game show and won the show as well. The Traitors, which I think I'm going to probably watch around Halloween time. So we'll already be about halfway done with Big Brother at that time. By the way, if you want to check out The Traitors, it's on Peacock. And some Big Brother favorites, Rachel Riley and Cody Calafiore, both winners of Big Brother. Below Deck's Kate Chastain. She just had a baby, by the way. Congrats. And one of the Bachelors, Ari. And I think a couple others. And then some Survivor. A couple reality stars and then some actual real people. I need to understand the concept of the show, but I'm going to watch it, like I said, in October. I'm going to watch The Traitors and see how that goes. So, but anyway, so his mom won Survivor. He's going into the house. I'm going to watch to see if him and Corey interact. Maybe he'll tell Corey his secret. I think that's the only way they would get to work together, like make an alliance, a Survivor alliance. But nobody else, Jared, no one else knows your secret. Nobody is going to know your secret, otherwise you're going to be in trouble. I don't remember if Zach won his season. Let me see. I'm looking it up right now. Survivor 42. Oh. He was the second person to leave Survivor 42. Zach Wartenberger. So, did Ciri ended up on the same series? Let's see. Okay, no, they didn't end up on the same series. Oh, I don't know if she won. I don't know if she won her series. So she's been on a couple seasons. So Jared's mom first appeared in 2006 on Survivor Panama, finishing in fourth place. 2008, she returned for Survivor Micronesia, placed third. Then she was on Survivor Heroes vs. Villains in 2010. Finishing 17th. She didn't win her series. I'm sorry. I thought she won, but she did win The Traitors, though. She did win that series. She was on Survivor Game Changers. This was, how long ago was this? 2017. And she finished in sixth place. So, was eliminated without receiving a vote. What was that? Was that the one that they had a tiebreaker on? I wonder. I'm curious. I think that was... Oh, I think she was the one where everyone had immunity. Yes. Oh my God. We have to look that one up. Okay. Cause that was the video that I saw and I was like, oh my God, how is this happening? So Ciri, his mom is famous because she got eliminated by default because everyone played an immunity idol. So she got screwed over that season. So that she was robbed of that season. I remember watching this video. So we're going to look that up in a minute. once we're done. Okay. Do I think he can make it to the end? I don't know, because look at him. His physique is on point. I think he will be a physical threat. He possibly can make it to jury, but if they find out his little secret, he's done for. So I don't know. Okay, let's move on, because I'm so excited. I want to get to that video. Kirsten Elwin, age 25, from Houston, Texas, a molecular biologist. Oh my God, so she's freaking smart, man. I need to date a scientist. And she's gorgeous too. See, this is what I love. I love gorgeous people like this going into science and stuff. See, 20, 30 years ago, you wouldn't even see these people doing science. You would only be the glasses nerds and all that. Time has changed since then, ladies and gentlemen, okay? Do I think she can make it to the end? Yes, I think she can make it to the end, but she needs to downplay that profession, definitely, because if they find out she's a molecular biologist, they're going to nix her for sure, because they're like, oh, you're smart. You're dangerous for this game. She could be one to get into a showman's too. So I would be careful, Kirsten. I hope you're dating someone. I hope you're with someone, because then that will make your game easy. So I have good thoughts for Kirsten. I think she will make it to jury for sure. I do see that happening. So, all right, Luke Valentine. Oh my God. This is the definition of the word meathead. Age 30, Coral Springs, Florida, illustrator. Now, even though you see the picture, Luke actually wears glasses. I have watched a video and I've seen him wearing glasses. Doesn't excuse him for the meathead personality. I don't know how his personality is. We're going to have to wait and see. Maybe I'm being judgmental. I'm sorry. I know I'm fat. I know I'm going to talk shit on the good looking people. So there we go. Welcome to my channel. But yeah, Luke Valentine, they're going to see, he's going to tell everyone he's an illustrator, but they're not going to believe it. They're going to be like, nah, he's something else. I think he's lying about his profession. And just especially if he goes in and does competitions. I don't know, Luke. You're not giving me good vibes. I don't know if you're going to make it to the end, to be honest. I kind of need to see what your personality is, and then maybe I'll have a change of heart. We'll see. We'll see. Can he make it to jury? I don't know. At this point, I don't know if he can make it to jury. So, anyway, let's talk about Matt Klotz. Age 27, Baton Rouge. I'll say Baton Rouge, Louisiana. He is a Deaf Olympics gold medalist. So Matt is our first. Well, he's not deaf, but you can tell by his speech. When you start hearing him talk, you can kind of tell something's going on there to where he is partially deaf. But nevertheless, he is our very first deaf person on the channel, on the series. A season of firsts, I must say. And there are videos of him competing in the Deaf Olympics. Go on YouTube and look that up. We might pull it up right now if we have time. So obviously he's athletic, and that's what they're going to be gunning for right off the bat. But if Matt can smooth people over with his social game, I do see him making it far. But he might be one of those guys that has to win competitions to save his butt. So I don't know if we'll get another Michael from last season. Michael impressed the heck out of me last year. But I think I picked him. I'm pretty sure I picked him for final two. Do I think Matt can take it to the end? I don't know. I do think he can make it to jury as long as he is good with everyone. Maybe win some competitions. Not too many, but just enough. And we'll see. Okay. So, next we have Nicole Hayes, age 30, from Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Sorry, I'm not good with initials. I should have just spelled them out. A political consultant. So, another smart one. And that's what I love right there. Stunning, gorgeous, and is into politics. I don't care what side she goes for. it's just that she's in politics and she's like freaking smart. So I love this about her. A little bit older than Kirsten, but shout out to both of them, you know. So I wonder if she's married. I think she has to be with someone, I think. If not, y'all are missing out, like, honestly. Do I think she can win? I think she could. She might want to downplay her profession as well, just because Xavier did that too when he won season 23. He told no one that he was a lawyer, and he somehow got away with it, made it to the end. I think she needs to do the same too. So have like a backup profession. Maybe say you're a bartender. Just say you're a bartender and you're good. I see potential. She definitely can make it to jury for sure. So we'll have to wait and see. We got two more house guests. By the way, we are less than 30 minutes away, folks. We're getting there. We're almost done. Let's meet Red Utley. Utley? I don't know how to pronounce his name, but whatever. Red. Let's just call him Red. Age 37 from Gatlinburg, Tennessee. Obviously. He's into sales. Okay. So sales, you got to have a good social game there. You're a people person. So he interacts with a lot of people. Judging by his picture, he must have a very good personality. Fun to hang out with. I just hope it remains that way in the house. He reminds me of a contestant from Big Brother Over the Top. His name was Cornbread, believe it or not. He wanted to be called that, apparently. So Red, I think, could be potential for America's Favorite House Guest. I don't know if he can make it to the end. If he makes it to the end, it's because he's going to be a pawn for most of this game. Which I can see. Because who's going to vote out Red? You have him next to Luke or Corey. Red is sitting pretty. Unless they decide to do a 180, which can happen, because remember, expect the unexpected. He can make it to jury for sure. I really hope they do. He can at least make it to jury. All right, and our final house guest, Riley Smedley, age 24, from Nashville, Tennessee. Bartender. She is a bartender, which makes sense. I also looked online. I believe she did sports in college, if that is her. And it had to have been not too long ago, I think, because she's 24 right now. So let's see, 19. So that's 5 years ago. So 2018, around 2018. Yeah. So she was doing basketball, college basketball. So, which means she's very athletic. So she might want to downplay that a little bit. Have a good social game. I have a feeling she's going to be part of the showmances too. She could be looking for one, and that's going to really screw up your game. Just saying. So she can make it to jury, I think, unless they decide to pull a Whitney on her, because Whitney from Big Brother 23, they nixed her before jury. So I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Okay, we're going to stop right there before I give my final two predictions. So, but I want to look up the videos. I'm just going to type it in real quick. Ooh, Bachelor Fan Take. I need to watch his video. Yeah, of course it was the season of Game Changers. Let me see. Okay, I'm gonna pick this one. Okay. So let me get this going right now. Okay. So this video is courtesy of Survivor Fan. So thank you, Survivor Fan, for posting this. This is Jared Fields' mother, Siri, on her fourth and final appearance on Survivor Game Changers. This is, she was voted out by default because everyone had an immunity idol and there was literally nobody else eligible for elimination except Siri. So you're going to feel some sympathy for her in a little bit. So let's watch.
I have an idol, it's a blue idol. I like to play for myself.
Okay.
And I have another one, a red one. I would like to play for Aubrey.
Oh.
Thanks, Ty. These are both hidden immunity idols. Any votes cast for Ty or Aubrey will not count.
Hey, Jeff.
Oh!
I've got a secret advantage, which is a legacy advantage. This is only good for right now, and I don't need a souvenir, so there you go.
All right. This is the legacy advantage. Any votes cast for Sarah will not count.
Wow. Yeah. There's Siri, by the way.
I'm going to get on the immunity train and do that because I just feel like being in the final five.
All right. This is also a hidden immunity idol. Any votes cast for Troyzan will not count. So, any votes cast for Ty, Aubrey, Sarah, Troyzan will not count. You could not vote for Culpepper. He had immunity, which means Siri. It doesn't matter what votes are in the urn, because the only person who can receive votes is you. And for what it's worth, not a single vote in here has your name on it.
Wow.
This is a historic tribal council. Most idols ever played at a tribal, 3. Most people ever safe at a tribal, 5. And the most significant and devastating part of tonight's history-making tribal for you, Siri, is you become the first person in 34 seasons to be voted out simply because there literally is no other choice. There's no need to re-vote.
Wow.
Siri, you came out here 11 years ago to play this game. You've played it 4 times now. You famously got up off the couch to see what you were made of. You had another moment this season where you conquered a personal obstacle. If this is the end of your Survivor run, what is the story?
This has been one of the most grand experiences of my life. It changed me. I would have never done any of this stuff if I didn't get off that couch 11 years ago. I would have never met so many different people. I would have never had so many amazing experiences. So it's bittersweet. However, I'm going out in grand style. It never happened before. And it just makes this experience that much more special for me.
Siri, how many days of Survivor have you played now?
Not enough.
Siri, I have to say, you've played every day of Survivor with grace, and it has been an honor to have you be a part of the Survivor family. You are the 15th person voted out of this season. You become the 8th member of the jury. You need to grab your torch.
Sure.
Wow. Just wow. Oh, Lordy. That's a devastating way to go. So, I'm trying to see if I can find a little clip of Zach Wurtenberger, and you'll see the resemblance. This video comes courtesy of CBS. And let me get... So I'll get this set up. By the way, we're 20 minutes away. And before the video ends, I will be giving my final 2 picks. So Just hang tight. Oh, I missed it. So the guy over here, you see, that's Zach. That's Corey's brother.
If anybody has an advantage or an idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Right up. I'll take the shot.
So, Zach, you took the shot in the dark.
Yeah, I took the shot in the dark.
Okay.
As a super fan, I know that if you've got whatever odds there are that you're safe and you can add 16% to those odds, I think you'd be silly not to take it.
So Zach sacrificed his vote. So there is not a vote in here from Zach. Instead, took a 1-in-6 shot at safety in the game. If that says you're safe, then any votes in here that are for you will not count. If you're not safe, any votes will count. All right, you're going to open it and then show it to all of us.
Let's see.
So what happened is he took a shot. There's a chance that he can save himself from elimination. But I guess the thing that he's about to open, it has to say that he's safe. Because if it doesn't, then he's still eligible for elimination. And if it does say he's safe, then no votes would be counted towards him. But if you see the title of the video, it doesn't look like it's going to work out for him.
Not safe.
Not safe. All right. Any votes cast for Zach will still count.
Sorry.
I'll read the votes. First vote. Zach.
Oh.
Zach. Two votes, Zach.
Yikes.
Second person voted out of Survivor 42. Zach, that's three. That's enough. You need to burn me your torch.
That sucks. Took a shot and you're the second person voted out. Maybe he'll come back and get redemption at some point. Let me see. I'm going to just play you a little bit of some cast interviews. So you can kind of hear. Just so you can get a feel of. Just so you can get a feel of what the cast sounds like. So this interviewer named Mike Bloom, he sat down and did an interview with the new house guest. So let me get this going real quick. Okay, so the interviewer, this is courtesy of Mike Bloom, by the way. He asked this first question. It goes for like an hour, but we don't have time. He asked the house guests what or how they feel about being a part of the house. So you'll be able to hear what they sound like now, most of them, and we'll go from there.
Huge deal. This is a big season to be on. I'm so excited and so ready to play.
This is America, by the way. Everybody's name will be listed, but I kind of skipped that part. But this is America Lopez. So
I can't believe that I get to be part of this historic moment. I'm ready to play.
I'm so excited to be part of Big Brother 25th anniversary. It makes it.
See, I love the accent. She's golden. I feel like her personality is going to be so awesome.
That little bit extra special. There's a bit more of a buzz going around. And we're out of COVID, so I'm so excited.
Being a part of Big Brother history is incredible. But being part of the 25th season, Silver Anniversary, I can't wait to see how nuts this gets. It means more to me that I'm a part of something in the quarter of it. It's 25, man.
Well, it's incredible. I mean, season 25, I feel like all of these milestone seasons, whether you think 10, 20, 25, they've all been spectacular. And to be a part of
Well, it's funny as he wasn't even born when Big Brother started. I believe 2002 or 2001, if he hasn't turned 22 yet. I don't think anybody's going to have a birthday in the house because the bios would have specified. So Yeah, he must have just turned 21 already. So 2002, it was already on season 3.
This season, it's incredible. And I feel like not only is it going to be fun for me, but it's almost my duty to make this season as amazing as it can be. So I'm looking forward to it. I hope everyone else is. Oh, I'm pumped. Especially showing up here where I'm like, I guess I've already been in the house, which is incredible to think about. Just the simple things. Walking, sitting at the kitchen bar, going outside, playing pool, probably being horrible at pool, going upstairs, sitting at the chessboard. There's just so many moments I want to have, and I'm going to be able to. It's going to be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even imagine what they're going to do. I believe they're going to bring in some old stuff, some new stuff, a combination of stuff. And I've racked my brain thinking, what are they going to do? It's the 25th season, so I know it's going to be crazy. And I'm just ready for whatever they throw at us. I think it's going to be exciting, and I can't wait to be a part of it. Well, I'm excited. I'm actually a little nervous because I thought it's the 25th season. They're going to do some crazy stuff, something we haven't seen before, I'm sure. There's going to be all kinds of surprises. You know, they say expect the unexpected. Well, for the 25th season, I'm assuming there's going to be a whole lot of that. So I'm excited to be a part of it, but a little nervous about what all of that unexpected could possibly be.
Yes, I am beyond thrilled to be on Big Brother season 25. This is a historic milestone, which means that this game is going to be more competitive. The house is going to be more interesting, and it's going to blow people out of the water. And I'm so thrilled to be part of something so big.
I mean, I think there's a lot of pressure being on a historic season. You know, historic seasons, maybe sometimes for the audience can be feel like a letdown, but not this season. Season 25 is going to be the best for sure.
I mean, dude, I've actually been thinking about this so much. Like, 25th season, that's insane. Like, the silver anniversary for Big Brother. And for me to be part of that season, also making history as the first Sikh Punjabi house guest on the show is so incredible. It's so humbling. And, like, I mean, you can tell my excitement through this already. And, like, I've told you about how it's my dream. So it's everything I could have imagined, and it's like the perfect season for it as well. I think representing my Sikh community is so important to me. You know, I wear a turban. This is how I represent myself every day. So to come to the show, be who I am.
Sorry, I said hijab. I meant to say turban. I need to make sure that that's noted.
Represent not only myself, but my family, my people, my community is means the world to me.
It's iconic. I was thinking about it last night to myself, and I'm like, this is not anything ordinary that any ordinary person can say they've been a part of. Essentially, I guess I'm going to be part of history.
The 25th season of Big Brother. I feel like they're going to make everything 25 times as hard, to be honest with you, but I think it's also going to be a little bit of a bigger reward. We'll see if I'm right.
So this is the 25th year of Big Brother. It's
say now he looks nerdy. Like, what the heck? I don't know. He's going to be very... I got to watch out for this guy. See how... He reminds me... You know what he reminds me of? It's Kyle from last season. Oh, my God. He was such a tool last year. That's who he reminds me of, is Kyle.
A special, momentous occasion. It's an anniversary. People are going to be watching pretty religiously, I think. People are going to be coming back to it who haven't seen it in ages. And there's just something special about that number. I don't know exactly what to say, but I got a good feeling about it. Instinct is telling me this is the season.
I am super excited and super thrilled to be on Big Brother 25, and I'm ready to get in the house right now.
I am so excited to be on the iconic BB25 season. I'm excited for all of the twists and turns. I'm sure we're going to see some things from the past and maybe some things from the future pop up. So I'm really excited for what's to come.
Being a part of Big Brother 25, I'm actually elated. It's something you watch it on TV and you can't really, you know, you can sit down on your couch and you can holler this and holler that about what you're going to do. But I get an opportunity to actually get to test that instead of saying, well, this is what I would do or that's what I would do. I get to be the one making those decisions, and that is exciting.
I can't even believe I'm here in general. like, this really isn't real life. I keep pinching myself. It's not, you know, I'm not waking up, so I'm assuming this is real. super excited to be here. I'm honored that I was chosen to do this, and it's historical and the 25th season. Like, this is awesome. This is so cool.
All right. So we'll stop it right there because there's one more thing I want to show you as we are down to the last 10 minutes before the premiere. This is in regards to the twist that's going on. We're going to take a quick look because prior to everyone moving in tonight, I'm not ready yet. I'm not ready. Sorry. We're going to take a quick look at in regards to the twist. So in regards to tonight's twist, we don't know what it is yet, but we have a clue as to what it could be. Three former house guests have snuck into the Big Brother house and has decided to cause mayhem. So let's take a quick look. Courtesy of CBS, by the way. That's Brittany Haynes from Big Brother 12 and 14.
We did it. We're in. No one's here. No one's here. Come on, Danielle.
And that's Danielle Reyes from Big Brother 3 and Big Brother 7 All Stars. Do I need to introduce this dude? I think you've seen this guy everywhere. It's Frankie Grande. Yes, Ariana Grande's brother and was on Big Brother 16 and competed on BB UK, Big Brother UK season 8, Celebrity Big Brother UK season 18.
Oh my God. Go get the time laser.
Yes.
Go get that big boy.
Okay, I'll go get that big boy.
Okay, here we go.
That's the time laser.
Oh, I thought I was the loud one. Oh my God.
Okay.
The moment is finally here. I'm gonna activate the time laser. Yes. Go back in time to our season. Yes.
Let's do it. It is time to rewrite history and take back the victories we so deserve. Okay.
Amen.
Bye-bye, Brigade.
The hit. So the infamous Brigade Alliance is the reason Brittany Haynes did not win Big Brother 12. It was an alliance that made it to the end, and Brittany was the last casualty in Final Four.
The Hitmen are toast.
The Hitmen Alliance is the reason Frankie did not win Big Brother 16. Derek and Cody. Derek would win the season, and Cody would go on to win Big Brother 22 All-Stars.
Sorry, yes. Derek, but I'm going to expose your little undercover secret.
Let's put some sugar in that bitter jury.
And I...
What? I pushed the wrong button. I'm sorry.
Be losing bitter jury. And I will... Sugar in that bitter jury.
Okay, so Danielle... Or the bitter jury is the reason Danielle did not win season 3. Because back then, in season 3, the jury would be able to watch any footage from the season to help them decide who wins. After that season, the jury was then sequestered. That rule was put into play. So, but yeah, I think Danielle was robbed of that victory, to be honest.
And I will not be losing my dignity on a slippery wiener this time.
That was the very first competition at Big Brother 12. They had to jump on a hot dog and go all the way to the other side. Brittany slipped off numerous times and actually got injured in the process. So.
Initiate final check.
It's ready. Let's do this.
See you on the flip side.
Three. Two, one.
All right. I have to stop it right there. I think that's the perfect place to stop. I think we're going to see this footage on the premiere. So we'll let you finish the video when the time comes. So, but we need to stop it right there because I now need to switch gears and move back to my presentation. Because it is now time. Just make sure it is now time for me to give my final two predictions as we are now 5 minutes away from the premiere. So let's find out. Drum roll, please. Who are going to, who I think is going to be my final two. I, every season since I've done the recap show, I have picked one guy and one girl that I think has the potential to make it to the very end. Now, one guy stood out from the rest based on great personality, and I think has what it takes to win some competitions, but still make peace with everyone in the house. The guy that I have chosen for my final two is Haisam. I think I loved his personality right off the bat. I think he will make good with everyone. I don't think anyone would want to vote him out. I don't see why when you've got other people that can be voted out before him. So that's my pick for the guys. Now for the girls, this one was actually pretty tough, but I finally narrowed it down to two. And I'm doing this based on the smarts. This one is based on smarts because I think this girl is very intelligent. She's very nice based on her interview. You heard her talk. She's giving me good vibes. And I really am going to push for this girl to make it to the end. So with that, the girl that I have chosen for my final two is Nicole Hayes. Yes, I just love, she's stunning. It was a toss-up between her and Kirsten, but I think because, and don't judge me on this, but I think because she's a little bit older, she's kind of lived life a little bit, and she, you know, maybe she's learned from her mistakes and all that. No hate to Chris, to Kirsten, though, because she, you know, she's very smart, and, you know, she probably has learned from her wrongs, too, so. But for this case, I'm going to go with Nicole. I really am hoping she makes it. So these are the two people. I would love to see them sit with each other on final two. But if not, I want one of these two sitting in the final chairs, in the final two chairs. So I'm going to be rooting for them. Let's hope that they get very far. I did say they can both make it to jury. So that's the good news. I don't think they'll be one of the first voted out. I really hope. I'm praying. The only time I've gotten my final two predictions correct was season 23 with Xavier. I picked Xavier to win the game. So I was very happy about that. All right. So Nick's Big Brother, let's talk about the recap show. So tonight is the premiere in 2 minutes. The first live eviction is going to be next Thursday, August 10th, meaning the first recap show is going to be Friday, August 11th. So definitely want to like, subscribe, and get your notifications so you can follow along. We're going to recap the season premiere and the first week in the house leading up to the first eviction. There's one last task we have to do before we officially start the season. We need to get everyone's picture on the memory wall. So I'm going to disappear for a second. Let me do this real quick. My face is going to disappear for a sec so we can do this correctly. And here we go. All right, so there's our memory wall, and every week when someone gets evicted, their picture will turn to gray until we are down to our last contestant, and that person will be the winner. So, and that is it. All right, let me get back onto the screen. All right, so that's it. Thank you so much, guys. I appreciate you joining us, counting down the last minute. It is time to switch over to CBS right now and get ready for the Big Brother 25 premiere. I'm so excited. I'm ready to do this. I can't wait for a new season of the recap shows. I'm ready to go. It's time for summer to begin. Remember, my email is nickmorales2012@gmail.com. Email me any questions about Big Brother, anything you want me to know, because I will be doing my homework and following up on some stories and all that. Snapchat is nickmorales96. I'm going to do my best to do eviction predictions this season. You can also follow me on Kick. MusicMan1714 is my username, and I'm under the name Niccolo Zone. I'm going to try to get on Kick more this season. But thank you guys for watching. It is now time to go watch the Big Brother 25 season premiere on CBS. Go watch right now. You can't really see, but there you go. time right now. Yep. All right. See you guys.